Lin-Manuel Miranda's name has become synonymous now with Broadway thanks to his smash hit, Hamilton. But before that blockbuster, there was In the Heights, Miranda's first big Broadway hit, a four-time Tony winner nearly 10 years ago. The high-spirited, Latin-infused musical In the Heights is the next offering of Virginia Rep. And joining us here on our show today are director Nathaniel Shaw, choreographer Carla Garcia, and Shea Gomez, one of the stars of the production. Good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
It
thanks
looks very New York here on the stage. I like that. Nathaniel, tell us about this show, because I remember when In the Heights came out and won the Tony, and it made a huge splash on Broadway, and then 10 years later came Hamilton. Right. So,
well, I mean, it's the piece that put Lin-Manuel Miranda on the map as a writer, and between In the Heights and Hamilton, he's become perhaps the most important voice of his generation in creating musical theater. He's the first to really infuse rap and hip-hop successfully into a musical, and it's just a wonderful collision of traditional structure of musical theater, but infused with a new sound that Broadway had never heard. So it's an incredibly exciting, exuberant piece.
So why did Virginia Rep decide to do this show now?
Well, for so many reasons. I mean, one, because this artist, Lin-Manuel, has sort of transcended and become this cultural icon even outside of the realm of musical theater. Also, it's such an important piece. It's about an immigrant community in Washington Heights, so it speaks to today's issues and concerns as well. And then also just to balance the season with something upbeat and exciting and dynamic for Richmond.
I understand the music is amazing.
Oh, the music is stunning. And again, there's such a collision of sounds. I mean, Lin-Manuel Miranda speaks about it and says he wanted it to feel like it does when you're walking down the streets of Washington Heights, that different music can be pouring out of different doors, from hip-hop to rap to salsa to reggae sounds. I mean, the collision of sounds that you hear in that neighborhood in New York is represented on that stage.
And Shea, you're going to sing a song from the show for
us
today. Talk a little bit about the music and your personal experience with it.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's such a dream. It's very contemporary, and like you said, a bunch of different sounds, so it's really fun to play with, really fun to delve into, and the lyrics are so huge. I mean, for Lin-Manuel, we know he knows all those raps. I mean, it's crazy, but delving into that and connecting to it and, you know, coming at it from a personal perspective, I feel like I relate a lot to Nina, my character that I play. Mm-hmm. And you'll hear a little bit in the song that I'll sing about her coming back to the neighborhood and, you know, people putting their hopes and dreams into this girl and her thinking so much of herself. And I don't know, just the lyrics and the personal connection, I really feel like everyone can connect to this show and everyone can connect to a different character or a song and see themselves on that stage with us.
Mm-hmm. And not only is there music, but there's a lot of movement. And Carla, that's where you come in. You're
yes.
the choreographer of the show.
Yes, I am. And it's just so fun to get to set movement on this musical. Because like they said, the music is just a fusion of so many different sounds, and to be able to play with that choreographically is really exciting. I mean, there's salsa, there's hip hop, there's jazz, and the cast that Nathaniel and I have assembled is just so capable of all of that. And, you know, so I think that it's just very exciting in general, like, to get to play choreographically with it.
And you know a little bit about the mind of Lin-Manuel
Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Thank you, Miranda. Because you are in the cast of Hamilton on Broadway.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am in the Broadway production of Hamilton, and I've taken a leave of absence to come and set In the Heights here at Virginia Rep, and it's been wonderful. So I have a firsthand experience with the team and with Lin-Manuel and Andy Blankenbuehler, who choreographed the original production of In the Heights, which won him his Tony, his first Tony, and he choreographed Hamilton as well. And so I've been around kind of the world and the structure they've created for the original production of Heights, and I feel like I'm influenced in a way that I can bring something to it that honors them and the original vision, but still have my own voice and mm-hmm. still play with, you know, new ideas as well.
And it seems like Lin-Manuel's shows have a heartbeat all their own. They have a special feel to them, and you have to translate that to the stage here locally.
Yeah, I mean, there's certainly a pulse mm-hmm. that is different than a lot of Broadway material. that hip-hop and Latin-infused music just kind of drives you forward with a forward momentum that is unusual for musical theater. And it's really invigorating to work on, and it feels like, for me, I'm having a very different experience relating to this script and score than I've ever had before, and it's incredibly refreshing.
Oh, hopefully that will all translate to the audience
as well. I think it will.
Sure. Yeah.
Well, we're looking forward to your performance, and let's tell people previews of In the Heights are tomorrow and Thursday, with the show opening on Friday at the November Theater on West Broad Street downtown. Now, the musical will run through July 30th, which is good because you're going to want to come see it again and again and again.